Good morning.
Good morning.
Good to see everybody. We're so excited that you've come to worship with us here on this special occasion. Of course, some of us call it decoration, and some of the new folks call it homecoming. What do y'all call it?
Homecoming.
The Yankee says homecoming. It's decoration.
Decoration.
Did anybody say homecoming other than their preacher up here? Well, I said a couple, so. We don't really care what you call it. We're just glad you're here at Old Bethel, and we think this is a special place, and I know you do too, and your folks that's gone on before us who were here honoring today, they thought it was a wonderful place, and I just pray that you'll continue to come to decoration here at Old Bethel, and you'll teach the little ones like Miss Poland's got up here, teach them how important it is to come. And I know I've said this before, I know we all complained because we were here 8 hours minimum. And we would have already been here 4 hours for decoration back in the good days, right? But thank y'all for coming, even if you can only stay an hour or longer. Don't forget, we got a potluck meal after, so hopefully you've brought maybe a favorite dish this morning. You're going to stay and eat with us this morning. And has anybody got any special announcements we need to pass along this morning to all of our friends and family that's with us today? No announcements today. Now, if you look in your bulletin, I passed those out. Most of you didn't. I think I told them as I was passing them out, Brother Steve, that they were $3, and nobody has paid yet. So, but just for y'all today, we're going to knock that $3 off, and there'll be no charge today. So that's pretty good. So we're going to be singing today out of two different hymn books. So if you'll get one kind of handy, we're going to start out with our Cokesbury hymnal. And then we'll end up with a celebration hymnal in the second part of our service this morning. So you see we've got some requested songs that's been requested. And I know Brother Steve has got a wonderful way to put this service together this morning. So once again, thank you for being here today. Hopefully you're going to stay and eat with us. And Pam's going to be providing the wonderful piano music to go along with her singing. So let's have a good time and worship the Lord this morning. At this time, I'm going to turn it over to our pastor this morning. Brother Steve Kennedy.
Good morning.
Good morning.
They weren't ready.
They weren't ready.
We'll do it one more time. Good morning.
Good morning.
Now, see, even the Lord could hear that one. That is good. Good to see you this morning. And good to have all of you here as we come today to celebrate, really to celebrate the past, to celebrate those who have been a part of our lives, who helped shape our journey in the faith as we were growing up. Many of you know, most of you know, that even as a teenager, I spent many, many days in this. This wasn't my home church. Belmont was my home church, but I think I spent as many days here as I did in my home church. So this, Old Bethel has a special place in my heart. I know Old Bethel has a wonderful and special place in your heart. And it is such a blessing to have you here. As you can see, if you'll look in the bulletin there that is in front of you, we're going to sing. We're going to sing a lot of songs. Songs often bring back memories. They restore memories, or they send us back to a fonder time, or a more joyful time, or an important, meaningful time. And so today we're going to use songs as we celebrate all the years past here at Old Bethel. Thank you all for coming, and thank you all for being here. And if you would, let me start, before we start with our music, let me open with a word of prayer, please. And Pam, if you'll play a little bit. Heavenly Father, it is good. It is good to come into your house today to worship you, to be with friends and family, to be with those who have touched our lives, who molded us into the people that we are. We thank you, God, for this opportunity. And God, as we gather here, we pray that your Holy Spirit will be upon us all, that we will feel your holy presence down in the depths of our souls, and our hearts and our minds will be open. Open to your Holy Spirit. Open to the memories of those who have touched our lives. God, this is a good day. It is always a good day when your children can come, when they can worship you, be with you. Thank you for everyone who is here. What a joy and a blessing. In Christ's holy name we pray. Amen. If you have your Bibles with you and would like to join with me in reading, I'll be reading from the Gospel of John, chapter 17, verses 20 through 23. John, chapter 17, verses 20 through 23. My prayer is not for them alone. I pray also for those who will believe in me through their message, that all of them may be one. Father, just as you are in me and I am in you, may they also be in us, so that the world may believe that you have sent me. I have given them the glory that you gave me, that they may be one as we are one. I in them and you in me, so that they may be brought to complete unity. Then the world will know that you sent me and have loved them, even as you have loved me. May the Lord bless the reading. This year we thought about how best to celebrate our past here at Old Bethel United Methodist Church. Especially how to celebrate it with those who've gone on before us. All of us here, we are all here because someone who called this church their home touched our lives. Today, we celebrate their contributions. Contributions of those who've gone on before us through songs and melodies. Songs and melodies that remind us of those precious saints who in their service to God made Old Bethel the place they called home. Even the place some of you once called home. Some who call it home even now. This morning, we begin where everything began for all of us. Throughout all of the years in this church, we have remembered the beginning of our faith. Our faith all began with the birth of a child in a manger on Christmas morning. So we begin with a Christmas song. God became man, and God came to earth. Christ was born for us. It is because of God's love for us. First we build in a manger. And all of us are here today. Now if you'll open your Cokesbury hymnal to the very back page, we'll sing "O Beautiful Star of Bethlehem."
Guiding the wise men on their way, under the blazing sun.
Those saints of our past made it their call to form, to shape their lives to the image of Christ. They took seriously the call of God upon their lives. And with strength and dignity, they lived lives and projected Christ in our presence. Through their faithfulness, we were nurtured. We were nurtured into what it meant, and what it meant to believe in who Jesus was. Now, if you'll turn in your coach, Barry, to page 60 for More Like a Master.
Brother Steve, if we were doing a service where we let people tell us what song they would want to sing, I remember a lady out there who said, let's sing hymn number 60, More Like the Master. Guess who that was? Gladys Wiggint. And, of course, Mr. Ernie Montgomery loved that song we just sung. So, More Like the Master, number 60.
Through His Holy Spirit would make them all that they needed to be. What they needed to be in order to win others to Christ, to rest in peace, knowing they had done all that they could do as servants of our Heavenly Father, to win each of us, all of us, to Christ. Now, if you'll turn to page 120 for an evening prayer.
Guess who would pick this one up? Miss Louise Northcutt. And you didn't ask her how old she was. I made that mistake, Mr. Fuller back there. I said, Miss Louise has got a birthday this week. I said, how old are you going to be? She said, you ought to know we's in the second grade together. She told that story a million times after that. But Miss Louise, this is for you.
Thank you.
They knew as they journeyed through this life, God would always take care of them. Through life's trials and troubles, as well as in the joyful moments, God would be there for them. All of his promises would be there for them. And they knew and they promised that in our time and in our day, the Lord would be there for us as well. Now if you turn to page 231 in your hymnal, his eye is on the sparrow.
Well, I had to double check to see who's one of these favorites. Y'all might have had one of her hamburgers up at Effie's Cafe. Anybody have a hamburger from Effie's Cafe? The others don't know what they were missing, right? His eye is on the sparrow. Trusted God, and he taught us to trust the Lord as well. Always with their hearts turned to God and holding on to God's promises, they knew. And they taught us to believe. There was a moment. It was a day. All of it coming for all of us. When everything around us be perfect. Turn to page 207. We're going to sing the first and fourth.
Oh, they tell me I went out.
this time, if our ushers will come, we'll receive this morning's offering.
Pick up the celebration hymnal. We'll be changing the hymnals. Okay. Celebration hymnal for our next few songs. Throughout the years, we gathered and we worshiped here together. Our family saints taught us songs. They taught our Sunday school classes. They taught us to pray. They taught us to believe. More importantly, they taught us to love the Lord our God with all of our hearts. To trust Him. To trust Him to guide us along in our journey. Now if you'll join with me at page 809 in the celebration hymn, that God will be there.
Y'all want us to go through it one time first? That's what we normally have to do. I'm up here sometime and we'll sing a song maybe we hadn't done in a long time, and I'm the only one I know because I'm the only one I can hear. And I said, well, since Pam played through it once, y'all can join me. So y'all help out this time. Don't be shy. Uncle Dallas is favorite, Miss Pam said.
Of our lives. And yet they knew the truth because they had lived life before us. None of us, not one of us, come before God as perfect people. But that doesn't matter. Jesus loves us as we are. And he would cleanse us from our sins and restore us through the power of his Holy Spirit. The cross made that possible. They reminded us. They always reminded us. It was never too late. Never too late to believe in Jesus. They join me at 486. Come ye sinners, poor and needy.
Jackie, this is Bill Williams' favorite, but it was number 23 in one of our old
hymnals
back then.
Okay. So this is Bill's favorite right here, right? Yes. Is anybody here today that's lost a loved one since we were here last year? I know we lost my brother Larry, and it's awful sad. And of course, I know Mr. Terry. Anybody else lost a loved one in the last year since you've been to Decoration Old Bethel? So we send an extra special prayer for you today. You know, we all have wonderful memories. I can remember Gary Fuller of asking Brother Calvin to lead us in a word of prayer right here at this decoration. And I sure would love to hear him pray one more time, or Mr. Bulis Reeves and some of those people that's gone on before us. And I'm not trying to leave any names out, but this is a wonderful family, even though we've kind of gone all of our ways. We go to different churches and all that stuff. But I tell you what, we've all got one thing in common. We love the Lord. Can I hear an amen?
Amen.
Amen. 486.
Thank you.
happened in our own lives. God's Holy Spirit reached into our souls and into our hearts. And we felt His presence. And we are assured that we were to be counted among the blessed. Now if you'll turn to page 505, for He touched me.
I want to say hats off to Pam. Doesn't she do a wonderful job? She's, thank you, Pam. It took me a while to get her trained. Didn't it?
Yeah.
She's still in training, she says. I'm kidding. This is Miss Lieber's song. He touched me. 505. Anybody else's favorite that y'all know of? Okay. I think everybody likes it.
God was still holding on to us. Sometimes we have allowed ourselves to slip away from the fullness of God's Holy Spirit in our lives. But all those glorious saints before us who had made the journey that we are now on ourselves reminded us there was no place that God's grace wasn't sufficient. Sufficient enough to bring us back. Back into the presence of God. Feel His Holy Spirit again. It reminded us of grace. Amazing grace. The amazing grace of God that never lets go of His children. Now if you'll turn to page 343 in your celebration
hymn.
So many, many before us. So many magnified the power of God and the lives that they lived. We are all, each of us, better because of them. We sang their songs today. Today we celebrate them. In each song, some of you were reminded. You were reminded of moments that to this day still shape who you are. These are precious memories. All of these are precious memories we share. Many of them, almost all of them, I can still see them. I can remember them. I am thankful for all of them. But you knew them better than even I. Your hearts were linked together by blood and kinship. More importantly, by God's Holy Spirit. All of them were one with you, as all of you were one with God. That is exactly how God envisioned for his church and his people to be. Today, they are all with Jesus, singing songs of joy and exaltation. And if you were to ask me, and even if you don't ask me, I think it might even be possible that where they are, they joined their voices with ours as we sang these songs this morning. And yet, they and we are all reminded. None of this, none of the hope that we have, none of the promises of God that we hold on to, nothing would have been possible, not even this moment, if it were not for Jesus Christ, our Lord and Savior. Through Christ, they have their victory. Someday soon, so will you and I. Till then, we will sing songs, we will pray, and preach, lifting all that we can up to the Lord, until one day, every life is a life that can find, a life that can find victory in Jesus. And now if you'll stand and turn to page 353 in our celebration hymnal for our closing song, 353, we're going to sing all the verses.
Thank you.
Let me remind you that immediately following the morning worship service of our service here, we will have a fellowship meal. And if anybody that's been back there knows, you should leave if you're back there. So it'll be a blessing to have you all stay and eat with us. And at this time, I'm going to ask Coach Reese, would you dismiss us with prayer and ask for a blessing?
Father, we thank you for this day, an opportunity to come together and memorialize those who have gone on before us. We thank you for all of those that impacted our lives, our parents, our friends, our relatives that were there for us and are still with us. And we thank you for them. Lord, we thank you for the opportunity to be here today. We ask your blessings upon the food that we're about to partake of. We just pray your blessing to our bodies, and we ask for your forgiveness for where we've failed and missed the mark, and we ask for your guidance and protection upon us as we leave this place. In Jesus' name, we pray. Amen.